So, introducing the characters.
So yeah, basically this is our protagonist, and then voiced by talented Minori Watanabe-san.
The seiyuu that we are working with are actually students. They are considered professional, but they are still learning. Actually, we like to work with, like I would say, anyone as long as they have the passion for the project.
That right, context, right? Yeah, communication definitely is one of our challenge, you know, to communicate with all the seiyuu. It's kind of very interesting and mystery stuff, you know, kind of this kind of I would say interaction and collaborations, and then you sort of like they found out our cultures and said, oh you guys did something this kind of thing over here, oh we don't know about that, and then we've been like, you know, the chemistry is very fun. So again, we have Asumi Sakamoto-san as our seiyuu. She loves chocolate, I would say.
Oh. Actually, I think this character is quite fun, as in because of her special talents, right? Yeah, I think a lot of people are kind of like amused by her special talent. People wants to have that kind of ability in real life.
I do wish I could have that ability.
Yeah. We all feel the same.
I think she's the kind of characters like who like everything organized and sorted out, right?
Yeah, and also side note, she is a little tsundere. So whoever likes tsundere, then yeah, this is your girl.
Tsundere, that is good. So next.
She is a genius, and she also very sporting, very outgoing, very likes, you know, outdoor kind of activities. And she likes walking around with friends, going out with a friend, so that's her personality. And she's voiced by someone who came from Hokkaido. Eleanor, you're one of your favorite, right? So
yes,
maybe you can speak more like what you like about her.
How do we say?
I would say very elegant. I mean,
yeah, elegant.
Very flow and character.
I know this is probably not a character that would be teased easily, but I feel like when you tease them, wow, it's going to be cute.
So yes, this is Qiu Yu. Siki?
Qiu Yu. Yep, autumn rain. She's a very shy girl, but very kind-hearted, basically.
What?
Likes to take stroll in parks, very good friend with IE. If you're curious why she's wearing different kind of uniform, the answer is she is a librarian. During the school that I had studied in the secondary school I studied in, it's something like this. I heard different kind of design, so I'm not too sure, but my school is the librarian definitely wear something similar to this. JY, how about your school?
Definitely not the ribbon, but yes, somewhat similar.
Actually, I do get questions like why are they wearing ribbon instead of tie? In Malaysia, right, we usually we just wear ties. But this is a deliberate design choice, basically.
This one wouldn't mind dating, to be honest.
That means that our character design is
working
okay.
Now, it's working.
The personality is also good. The personality is also good.
Our Neko-chan.
Yes.
Right? I mean, CK set it up like she likes to obviously cosplay, and then she likes to collect cute clothing and stuff, right? Also, very surprisingly, there's Himawari Koga-san. Like, she also likes collect
costume.
Yeah, costume. More like those, like a lot of flowery patterns kind of clothing. So usually she will stroll around, I believe, like market areas or anything to find this interesting clothes. One thing she shows us is like traditional, Chinese kind of clothing with dragon and stuff, right?
Oh.
One of her collections that she's shown to us. Yeah, fun fact.
That looks, you said like very good with rhythm games. I'm guessing there's going to be like a mai scene, perhaps. Is that going to make an appearance by chance? Like an arcade episode?
Maybe.
Hopefully.
Also, it's very mysterious yet very interesting, you know, the people that we ask to voice, right? The seiyuu, their work hobbies somehow related to the character they're acting.
That
for example, the Sakamoto-san, she likes to eat chocolate, I mean a lot. In this case, Cai Yun, right, the Tsugumi Amori-san, she loves to, you know, train muscles and sports as well. Because when we are auditioning, we do not know what they like and then what's their hobbies. We just judge based on the voice. Is it suitable? or should we change to other people's? But end up, okay, surprisingly, they have the same hobby.
That's good. That's honestly really good. So let's hear more about it. Like, how did you audition for that? Like,
actually, for the local like voice audition, we still haven't finalized yet. There are still a lot of things that we have to plan it out first, because it's kind of different with the Japan one. But for the Japan one, first I have to write down all the voice line and then for the characters and stuff, and also write out the character profile, that kind of thing. So once they get everything, they have to send us a video, audition video, so we can view it, because we are not there, right? So they have to send us the audition video and then we pick from that. Also, there are voice coaches there, so we will give them our input and stuff, like maybe her pitch is a little bit too high, maybe the way she speaks is a little bit too cute, that kind of thing. So we have to give them feedback, so they are back and forth. After all that, then we came out with these 6 voice actors or seiyuus.
All of them done it very professionally. I mean, they even do some imagine training of their character that they are going to act out as. It was very surprised. I mean, to our surprise, because at first we thought that okay, maybe they are a student, so the quality we are looking for maybe somehow not as much, right? But end up well.
Let's talk about Xing Qiao, right? Xing Qiao is a foodie. I want her to plant her own vegetables or in her own balcony kind of garden. Once I send this kind of thing to the Seiyuu, those also started doing the same thing. Her response was like, okay, I want to try to get into the character. So that's why she started this kind of hobby as well. And also, speaking of their classes, if I'm not mistaken, because they have classes 2 days a week. One classes is like script reading, that kind of thing, and then of course like train their voice stuff. And another one is singing. So if let's say you guys want to follow them, right, you can actually find their Twitter link on our website.
Oh!
Yeah, give them follow. Yeah. Yeah.
But just side note, of course, you know, I would say one is they only speak Japanese. They might be a little bit shy in interacting and so on.
Hey, they sing Malay. Wait, do they sing Malay in the music video?
For this time around, we will be using Japanese. But we do have plan to dub it into other language in the future. Because right now we are still trying to figure out like what's the best way of doing this, right? Because it's quite new in Malaysia.